What's new? What's now? What's next? This is 8 News Now with Dave and Dana.
Good morning, everyone. Just about 5:30. High winds take over southern Nevada, and this morning, folks all over the valley are cleaning up by that mess left by Mother Nature.
And they got to go find their garbage cans.
Yeah.
The gust started yesterday afternoon, went well into the night, and it wasn't only annoying folks walking and driving around town, but some of those trees didn't hold up very well. This one near Lake Mead and Michael Way. That thing came down, and now they got to figure out, well, what do we do now?
Yeah, a lot of folks sending in pictures this morning and last night. Some trees fell by their cars and all sorts of stuff, so that's never fun.
Ooh.
All right, let's check in with Sherry, see what we got going on. Is it over?
Well, taken to Sunrise, everybody expected to be okay.
Well, two people ended up dying in that fiery wrong-way crash we first brought you as breaking news yesterday, and it happened on the 95 near Boulder Highway. 58-year-old Ramiro Mesa from North Las Vegas was hit and then killed in the crash. 20-year-old Mario Valencia also died. He's the one who actually caused the wreck. NHP says he traveled at least 4 miles in the wrong direction before slamming into the victim. It's still too early to tell if alcohol, drugs, or distracted driving were any factors in that crash. But at first, the victim was in the hospital, ended up dying later in the day.
Saving money is among the most important issues for families here in Southern Nevada.
Yeah, that's why we asked our Michelle Mortensen to find some creative ways to save money on entertaining your kids this summer. And boy, it gets hot in Las Vegas, Michelle, so we know movie theaters are a great place to go.
Hey, can't you just smell the popcorn through the screen, Dave and Dana?
I actually
let me tell you, it's good.
I know, we actually can, but we were saying how good it does smell.
Yeah.
It's just one of the best smells in the
world.
That's
why we'll pay $9 for it.
Yeah.
It smells so good.
Thanks, Michelle. It is pricey, isn't it?
Hey, I'm reading about our neighbors in the paper.
I know, right down at the Riviera,
the
right?
The Riviera, since they're going to spruce up the place, put $30 million into it. And one of the reasons is that the Sahara's coming back to life.
Right.
As the new, whatever that's being called.
Yeah.
Something. And so then, you know, kind of reinvigorate that
corner. It'd be nice if that Fountain Blue would finish, too. And then we'd have a really spiced
sure
up section.
It's good to have our neighbors, though, sprucing things up.
Yeah, it is.
Nice job, Riviera. Endangered animals are 537 now, all day today. A focus will be put on endangered species.
That's right, with 1,800 overall. There are some right here in Southern Nevada, believe it or not. All you got to do is go over to the shark reef at Mandalay Bay, and that's where brave Jessica Lovell is this morning, outside the tank, right?
Yes. That's a safe place for me to be, Dana. Good morning. Hey, everyone. Yes, Endangered Species Day, and we are. We'll come back up. We'll be back here live in about a half hour.
Okay, sounds good. Thanks, Jessica. A lot of fun over there. Take the kids.
It's cool, and it's tough to spot those sea turtles.
Yeah, it is.
You know, it takes a while to locate them. Very elusive in there.
They're not going to have the shark tank up in Salt Lake City. Maybe they will. I don't know.
But somehow we'll have it here. Whatever, you know, Dave will come back on visits.
Yeah,
we'll be here ready for them.
Popular songs. Yeah. They play it at the clubs. They play it at weddings. The queen of disco is being remembered across the world this morning. Donna Summer passed away yesterday after a battle with cancer. The video that you're looking at that we're going to show right here was actually when she performed over at the Las Vegas Hilton several years back. Local entertainer Tony Saka shot the footage and dropped it off for us. Summer won 5 Grammys during her career. She was only 63 years old.
Hey, when hot stuff comes on the radio, you just turn it up.
That's right.
Can't do anything but just turn it up. Wayne Newton could soon be without his home.
All right. Looks good. I know. It's nice that we have a day like that because we're celebrating Dave's last day at Channel 8. He's been here 20 years. Mm-hmm. Been showing some old clips, which we're going to show in a minute, but we wanted to give you a couple goodbye parting gifts. Here's a picture that we all took in the studio of the entire team for your
awesome
desk at Salt Lake City.
That's right where it'll go.
Everyone in the control room, our directors, and Paul, our studio
that's
crew,
nice.
Chris, and everyone.
There's the football we throw around.
Yep, so that's a great picture.
Yeah.
And then Brian, Sherry, and I wanted you to have a power tie for the first day. So we traveled all the way to Tiffany and got you something we think would look nice.
Ooh,
with
nice.
Maybe your brown suit.
Yeah.
Isn't that nice?
That is awesome.
That's the good stuff.
You're starting off with a labeled tie right there. See that?
You know
isn't
what that
nice?
Is? That looks like cowboy colors right there.
yeah, it does.
You know
does
somebody.
So I'm picturing your brown suit, the blue shirt, and that tie.
Okay.
First
I like
day.
That.
May 29th up there.
Nice ensemble.
Thank you.
Looks
very
good.
Somebody's going to say, oh, wow, the new anchor wears Tiffany ties.
Yeah, I know.
Ooh. They might take you seriously.
He must be from Vegas. All right, well, let's show you right now. We've got some clips from through the years. Enjoy this, everyone at home. It's a lot of fun. We put it together a few days ago. Take a look.